I'm just updating social media real quick. I'll start in a moment. Excuse me. Like a Bucky player.
You. after this. Yeah, guys, but if you want to ask me some questions or want to talk or something, you always can, but else I'll just be working on this. I love this song. Fucking chill. It kind of fits the picture, I guess. Yeah, dog, that's it. Oh, let me sip on my coffee. Good to be alive. Should be a little bit darker, I think. Come on, bruh. We ain't cool. Thank you. We're really getting the feels. The rainy feels. Feels good, man. comprehends. Fucking piece of shit. There we go. Thank you.
booby.
Oh yeah. Oh my fucking god. Frame rate is a bit scuffed. It's a little bit better now, I think, because I closed the other document. Thank you. Come on, bruh. Clearly there are pixels. The fuck you talking about, man? She walked down the room. Sister of the moon. That's better. I bet she knew. Stop. Oh yeah, I love that screaming guitar. Oh, I got goosebumps. I forgot this solo. From Japan. Text Omega Lul. Yeah, I speak in Twitch memes, by the way. I'm not proud of it. Well, I am actually, lol.
All lies.
Could he play guitar? Thank you. Kazakhstan. Oh, I forgot how much I love the song. That witch voice. Hey man, can you hear me, David? What's up, dude? Am I really the only one on the whole website streaming? Yeah, you can hear me. Good, good, good. That doesn't seem good for the website. Now you can hear me probably. But that's not too great of a sign for a website. You know, not the best this website. I mean, I like this website, but it's kind of weird. You know, like there's nobody streaming at all. Imagine that happening on Twitch. Yeah, that's a completely different scale, of course, but. You get my point. The previous song, this is Kate Bush. Both are Kate from Kate Bush. This one is more well known. But I love this shit, man. A little bit psychedelic. And that 70s guitar sound, you know? That squealing, a little bit screaming guitar. Oh, I booped the mic. Excuse me, but good to see you again, David. Awesome. Have you been practicing some more? Because I talked with you about studies and stuff, right? I think that I'm pretty sure that was you the other day. Nice. Yeah, man, just keep going. At one point in like 2012 or something, 2013, I just studied like a fucking madman. I would like 8, 9 or 10 hours a day I would be studying. And if you can keep that up for a while, you learn super fast. And of course also draw from imagination to try to memorize your study. So that's what I do. Do a study and then like 1 or 2 hours later I draw something from imagination that includes what I've been studying, you know? That's a really good way for me at least to solidify things in my head, you know, to make them stick. Because else I can definitely forget. And then you're kind of wasting your time. Well, not really, but yeah, you can be more effective if you test your memory, I think. And make notes if you can. Have a little bit of small little notebook on your desk. That helps too. I don't want to be be lecturing you or something, but you know, maybe those are things that work for me, so who knows, hopefully they work for you too. Yeah, no problem, dude. It's very when you really start learning, it's very scary because you realize how much you have to learn. But also it's exciting. Like you can see, like, oh my god, I can get so much better. I can keep getting so much better. It's limitless. So it's both for me. Now you're probably feeling that as well. Yeah, sure, man, that's a good attitude. Just keep doing that. You have to be receptive for knowledge and not be ashamed that you don't know something yet, but you want to learn it. This solo is fucking spicy. I still have this weird ass bug in Photoshop. Yeah, man, that's great. It's never too late to learn. The whole attitude, like, some people are like, oh, you're, I don't know how old you are, but some people are like, oh, you're over a certain age and now you're too late. But those are just people who stopped learning themselves and are just kind of trying to drag everybody who's still trying to learn down, because they feel like losers, and they are if they don't change that mindset. Yeah, exactly. The 41, it doesn't really make a difference, you know. If you keep practicing, in 5 years you can be just as good as somebody who's been drawing since like somebody who's 25 who's been drawing since he was 20. And maybe that sense of urgency that will motivate you to practice more than you would have done when you were younger. So that will only make you better quick, you know, more quickly. Just no reason to see things in a negative sense, you know. There are enough people doing that. Yeah, man. We just gotta keep motivating each other, you know. Make a deal with God. Oh, making these nice smooth lines is always so satisfying. It's kind of meditative, you know. I don't have to think that much, it just, the reptile brain just takes over. The part of your brain that you've been practicing for so long kind of goes automatic now. The reptile brain. Yes. This moment from you now. Yeah, that's hard to make an estimation of, because it was a inked drawing for Inktober, in the first case, and then like a few like a week ago or something, I started doing the digital lines. Here, this is the original drawing, really rough, but so this one probably took in ink maybe 3 or 4 hours, and this one also a little bit more, like 6 or 7 hours. Getting the lines to look nice always takes me a little bit longer, so that would a little bit like kind of around 10 hours I think in total, maybe, or 8 or something, I don't know. That's the best I can do. The best I can predict. But I'm a lot faster with traditional for now still. I can definitely draw something like this in pencil in 2 hours or 1.5, 1.5 hours even. But yeah, if I do an inked layer above it, then it takes a little bit long, at least like 1/2 hour longer, and digital lines even longer. Yeah, I can really make it look nice though, so. Yeah. Pencil is just the most accessible, most direct way to draw, you know. You're like, your hand is directly on the paper, so you can make super nice lines. This is the tablet is still a sort of an input device, you know. It's I'm not drawing where you see the line happening, but I do practice my lines a lot. Check this out. I try to do this every day. So doing just lines and stuff from my arm, so not from my wrist. You see, it's just from my shoulder and my elbow. I don't try to do those little wrist movements. At one point, I had like a really bad wrist injury because I pressed too hard and did too much with my wrist. You get what I'm trying to show you, right? Alfonso Dunn. Never heard of that person. Let me see. Ah, okay. Drawing tutorial books. Ah, yeah, like this a little bit, yeah. I see the resemblance. That's pretty cool. Babushka, yeah. Babushka, babushka, yeah. Thank you. But yeah, what you said, like, I'm the only person streaming at the moment. It kind of makes sense now you said it, because I wasn't getting paired up with anybody. So I was like, what the fuck? Maybe it's like a bug or something. But yeah, there's nobody to pair me up with. Just hitting some MMJ before I start coloring. What do you mean with MMJ? There's four people in a room, you wait. Otherwise... Yeah, this is the only time I use my wrist, it's when it's really fine movements. But sometimes I even use my elbow for this. Ah, medical marijuana. You're probably from the US then, right? Yeah, I've never heard a different country, somebody from a different country talk about weed like medical marijuana. But then you're probably not in a state where it's legal for recreation. Because there are some states it's just, you don't even have to have a license, right? That's really the way to go. Yeah, but I live in the Netherlands, so we've had recreational marijuana, I think since like the 70s. I can just go get it in coffee shops, which I do sometimes. Yeah, you should come to Amsterdam. One time, it's not only weed, you can get magic truffles, so like magic mushrooms, you can get those in the shops too, in smart shops, completely legal. Well, you shouldn't be like walking the streets high out of your mind, of course, but because then the police will have a talk with you. But if you just take it home and do it, that's completely legal. Yeah, but you're not allowed to smoke a joint outside here either. If you're like standing in the middle of the street and the police come by, then they won't arrest you, but they will definitely make you put the joint out or just take it outright. You know, you can do a lot here, a lot is allowed, but you should not be testing the police's patience, you know, that's not a good idea. Hey, what's up, Marina? Breathe, breathe, nicotine. But yeah, David, the same goes for alcohol, and I assume that's in America as well. You cannot be like standing outside drinking hard liquor. But I'm happy they do that, because else there would be drunk fucking idiots everywhere, probably. Drunk baboons. Yeah, we finally have a partner. Just doing a little bit of a stretch. Yeah, man, you're welcome to. You can still chat then. What are we gonna do? What are you going to do, David? wanted.
He's gonna do it! He's gonna do it!
Prepare your buttholes. Fuck.
Thank you.
tomorrow. Hey, what's up, man? What's up, chat boy? Asia Sistri. How do I say your name? Asistri. Hey, thanks, boy. Thanks, my boy. You come from Robos, or you're just somebody who just randomly found this? Look at them boobies, boy. Thanks so much, man. On your friend list. All right. I wonder where I know you from. Let me see. Didn't know this. But cool that you're here anyways. Fucking awesome. Yeah, you are. I see. But I forgot where we know each other from. But that doesn't really matter, right? But yeah. Let's work on them boobies, boy. Yeah, then it gotta be Bulldog. Yeah. Welcome to the Kappa Clap. Thanks for 7. It's been a while since I watched Bulldog, though. So I don't know what the newest memes are. The last meme I was there for was Pepega. Pepega Clap. Mr. Streamer, I want to help Pepega. But knowing Bulldog, there are definitely some new memes already. Question mark? I don't understand, Pepega. I love Pepega because it's such a crappy emote. It's just a feels good man morphed with Liquify in Photoshop. But that's why it's so glorious, you know? It's such a piece of shit. Pepega, that's the way of life. But yeah, it's always funny, you know, how people find your stream. Yeah, because I've been part of a different streaming community, so I expect people to come from that. But then all of a sudden, somebody from Bulldog from that time comes, and it's really awesome. I've been watching a lot and participating in the community of Robos. I don't know if you heard of him. He's also a Swede, like Bulldog. And he's also somewhat autistic. Lil. But in a glorious way. Robots. If you like Bulldog, you probably like him too. Not exactly the same, of course, but also like a little bit pushing the limits of what's acceptable these days, and I love that. Do I not have the category set? Is it not on Twitch Creative? Let me see that, dude. Thanks for letting me know if that's the case. It does say here, look, make an education section. It doesn't for you? This is very good that you say this, because then I can change it. I wasn't aware of this. But it doesn't say, it doesn't show up in the creative tab. Okay, let me try this. Oh damn, you're right. I think they changed that. It used to be creative, I think, Twitch Creative. But you're right. It's art now, you see? Thanks, man. You saved my ass. Creative search. So let me update this whole thing then. How many tags can I have? Because this all applies. Yes. No. You can say whatever you want. But I will smash that ban hammer if it's some racist shit. Well. What? Oh, damn, man. Thanks. Wait, let me check if it shows up now. Here, this is the guy I was talking about, by the way. He's still streaming. That was, we were just talking about Pepega. That was a real Pepega move for me. that was pretty much the personification of Papega. Creative. I know what the picture looks like. Beauty and body art, otherwise known as an excuse for girls to be naked. Feels fucking good, man. No, some are legit art though, but you know what I mean. Oh, here it is. Grill. Pepe hands, I'm so far down. That's a bulldog, an old school bulldog reference. Where are we at? Ooh, some cute anime boys. Gachibas. Wait, I should be somewhere around here then. Sure. Omega lul. Well, I don't have zero viewers, so I should not be here. My patience is wearing thin, and this is not gonna help me get viewers. Nah, fuck it. But that's a good idea. Let's spice the title a little bit up. You are a smart boy. Yeah, this is a reference to RoboStream, so it's maybe a little bit too niche. Don't order against TOS. TOS Monka is. Feels fucking bad, man. And some chicks can just show their ass on stream. Monka is TOS. Probably not much better, but maybe I'll come up with something better. Oh, David, I didn't see you comment. I was on Twitch. Yeah, it used to be Twitch Creative, so the tag used to be correct, but now it's art, and it didn't link it, so feels weird, man. Surface Pro. No, what's that? You mean the program? This is just Photoshop, but or maybe you mean something else. Please enlighten me, sir. But I'm probably not on it because I don't even know what it is, so.
But I want to know. Tell me the secrets.
Fucking piece of shit Photoshop. Microsoft Surface Pro. Oh, that's like a drawing a tablet, right? So sort of like an iPad, but you can draw on it. Something like that. I think I've seen other artists talk about that. If it's what I think it is. Yeah, no, I'm on a Wacom tablet. Just a normal desk drawing tablet. I can show you. I'm not sponsored, by the way, so. Damn, son, you have a Cintiq? That's dope, sir. Cintiq is awesome. I wouldn't mind having that one as well. I have this one. Pretty awesome. It's pretty good. Yeah, that one. It's really it has a lot of it's real sensitive. I had a Intuos Generation 3 first. That thing was fucking ancient. It worked well though. look at this early or this late 2000 design. But this one is a lot better. You mean the tablet is good? But it's really funny, dude, that you saw me in your friends list and you saw Streaming Creative and you're like, let's check this motherfucker out. Let's check what, let's see what this Pepe guy is doing. Feels fucking good, man. All because of the B-Dog.
I'm 12, by the way.
Bowie, Pepe Hands. Mommy, no. Be dog. Be God. Syndrome, Omega Lul. At least he's better than Syndrome, Omega Lul. Sint Lul. She can spit in the eye of fools. Look at them cavemen go. Yeah, but Aces, if you have a question or something, or something specific you want to talk about, just put it in chat, man. You don't have to, of course, but I'll just be working, you know, if I don't have anything to talk about. So I hope you don't mind that. But if you want to talk a little bit, that's fine too. I can work and talk at the same time. Sure. I'll put my Instagram in the chat. You can follow me if you want, if you like it. Man, being up the manga. I need some more followers. There you go, sir. I have quite a reasonable amount of posts already. Yeah, man, I appreciate you. Some alien ass beat. And aliens are singing. Thanks, bro. Thanks. I've been doing it for a little while, so. But yeah, I really appreciate your nice words, man. There were times like I never showed my artwork at anybody, so it's still a new thing to see people react to it in a positive way. Always puts a smile on my face, for sure. There we go.
Ding.
Yeah, but I've been really finding out what a warm and welcoming community Twitch has. I mean, there are a lot of course, toxic situations in chat sometimes, but for all those toxic situations, there are also a lot of really nice people who just want to support you if you provide them with entertainment or good gameplay or something. It's really quite amazing. I really feel accepted on Twitch always. Oh, that's fine, man. That's fine. you can just see my updates if you like my artwork. Thanks, bro. Thanks for hanging out, man. This was very how should I say this in English? A very special meeting, you know, like random somebody from a long while ago. So I really like that. Thanks for hanging out, man. It really means a lot. And I hope to see you again. And my tablet just stops working all of a sudden, Pepega. Yeah, I try to stream like two, three or four times a week. Does it depend? But yeah, like three times is the aim for now. I always 100% stream on Tuesday, and the rest is kind of random for now. So Tuesday I'm always on. Yeah, good to meet you, dude. I mean, I guess we are already kind of met, but this feels like a first meeting, yeah, for sure. To my Twitch, you mean? What did you mean by add description? Where? On Twitch? Resident Sleeper. Feels good, man. All right, I'll do it. I thought I had a description. I should really get on my shit. Yeah, I only have like that intro text, but not a description, I guess. Yeah, thanks, bro. I'll do it. Do it. Feel better.
It's starting to share your link in related groups, community Twitter.
I don't even have a Twitter, so, but that's kind of a good idea. I should probably make one, right? And share my Pepega nature all across the internet. Hey, bye, man. Sleep well. Thanks for hanging out. Fucking piece of shit.
Work.
Okay, now it works all of a sudden.